All right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's Mary Boye here tonight. And how you doing? Hope you had a nice day. Our today's broadcast is just an interactive session, questions and answers, and I'll be having that with you. As you can see, on any topic, even though if it is the last just concluded topic, all right, we are here to do this. All right, please, I want to say, let's hold on a little bit till we give the intro. We already know the number. I'm going to give the number again. The numbers to call on 08092222. That's 2 in 4 places, then 164. That is the available number for this particular edition of the interactive session with Mary Boye on topics that has to do with our relationship, love, dating, our marriage, sex, etc. All right, so I'm going to go ahead to type in the number once again. The number to call is 08092222164. So that is the number to call. If you are calling from outside Nigeria, just make sure you add +234 and remove the first zero. Then you dial the number, it's going to go through. All right. For today's interactive session. Yes. God bless you. Just as we've been interacting together directly or indirectly, whenever there is a broadcast, you interact with me with your comments. But tonight is going to be a call-in interactive session. I'll be expecting your calls. Whatever question you want to ask in any related issues that has to do with your relationship. Now, if you want to make yours confidential, there is no problem making it confidential, okay? So there is a call coming in now. I'm just going to go ahead to pick this call so we can just start. God bless you. You're welcome. Hello?
Hello, good evening.
Good evening, sir. That's your first caller tonight. How you doing, sir?
I'm fine. Am I through with that? Is this Mary?
Yes, this is Mary. We are live online now. This is the live broadcast on the interactive session, so every other person can hear you also. Yes, it's live. It's live also. It's live. People are watching. Okay, it's there. It's my page, Mary Boye. Not the profile. It's the page. The live is on now. I can see people joining. Yes. So how can we interact tonight, sir? And may I know your name and where you're calling from?
Calling from Lagos, I'm in Lagos.
All right, sir.
I would like to know. Hello, I would like to ask. Are you there, please?
I'm here, sir.
For what you discuss, I would have loved if you make your biblical reference.
Okay.
Some of the arguments. It's quite interesting, but I would appreciate if you make some biblical reference.
All right.
Because most of us, we always like guided. There are some people who are not scriptural, they are not really.
Okay.
I would appreciate that, Father.
All right, that is very okay, sir. Now, because we have to limit the scope so that I'll be able to outrightly answer the question, in what aspect, which particular one exactly?
All right, that is very okay, sir. Now,
hello?
Okay. So, precisely, what do you want me to know? What do you really, are you asking me to be very precise or what?
Yes, you know, you said I should give you biblical support to all the teachings we've had, probably on sex. So if you can narrow it like asking a question, then I will be able to come up with an answer supporting it with the Bible.
Okay, the first question I would like to have on your past discussion, you made mention about oral sex. What precisely in the Bible is this question?
Yes. Okay. All right. Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Sorry, remind me your name. You're calling from Lagos. I know you're calling from Lagos. All right. Mr. Noel is calling from Lagos, and he's asking the question that, what is my biblical support to saying that I don't encourage oral sex? Now, outrightly, I may really not be able to pin out a passage from the Bible, but one thing I've understood from the scripture is all the sexual acts, okay, they were done normally. Because if you study your Bible very well, the Bible will say, and Noah knew his wife, and Adam knew his wife, and he conceived and begat a son. Can you hear me, Mr. Noah? All right, sir. So if you look at the Bible that way, okay, this person knew his wife and he begat a son. Now, whatever type of sex that will make you to conceive, that will make your wife to conceive, to begat a son, must have been the normal sex and not the oral one. So apart from looking for a place in the Bible to support that, also, it doesn't look hygienic. Are you getting it? It doesn't look hygienic. If you want, for example, a man puts his male organ in the mouth of the wife, it's like a disorderliness. Are you getting it? It doesn't, because the vagina is already created for it. That is just, God did not create mouth for us to accept the sexual organ. Yes. Yes. All right, no, I don't mind. I don't mind. Yeah, because there are 1,001 people waiting also to ask their questions.
Okay. All right. Let me just hang up now. Thanks very much.
You're welcome, sir. Yes, sir. All right. Bless you, and do have a great night, sir. Yeah. Another caller. Hello.
Hello. Good evening.
Good evening. What is your name and where are you calling from? This is Mary Boye. We are live. Now, this is an interactive session. It's a live broadcast on Facebook.
Yes.
Okay.
My name is Kenny. I'm calling from Lagos.
All right, Kenny, good evening. So, what is the question?
Yeah, I saw the caption of this live broadcast.
Okay.
And I've been following the series of the teaching and doing on Facebook.
Okay.
I really appreciate them.
Thank you
so much. I'm going to... One of my questions is on my current status as a single personality.
Okay.
And that's going to be on the proposal side.
Go on.
Yeah. Yes, we have the, like, we used to know, and we used to, you know, discourse.
Can you speak louder a little bit, sir?
Okay.
Yeah.
I said, like, I used to know, and like, I used to discourse and meet my fellow single brothers.
Okay.
And we used to also see movies and so many other displays on social media concerning proposals.
Okay.
So, but then I would like to know, yes, we have some other denominational standards that some other people follow in making proposal to someone who's getting interested, you know, in hooking up with. So I would like to know if there is a standard biblical, you know,
on the way to propose.
Proposal can be made.
Can be made. All right.
In a godly form.
Okay.
Looking at the way most proposals are being made, can we have a kind of biblical standard?
Okay.
That will make a proposal to be godly. And you know, appreciated by God, appreciated by even the person who is making it.
All right, thank you so much. That is a very clear question, and I'll go ahead to answer it. Mr. Kenny is asking that, is there a specific way we can make proposal that guys can propose to ladies, and God will be pleased, while the other person too, we also appreciate it. Now, I've not come across a place in the Bible that where there is a specific law that this is the format by which you can make your proposal, because we are different human beings. You as Kenny, you are different from Noah that just called earlier, okay? Now, and your background also is different. We are coming from different backgrounds. Now, your denomination, if you are a Christian also, we also have some factors that it will influence on the way you can propose. So there is actually no specific way to propose. All you just have to put into consideration, make sure you are sure of what you are about to do, make sure God is involved, make sure the other person is, you are not a stranger to this person you are going to meet, make sure you also respect him or her, you also respect this person, and put all these things into consideration and you will be fine. Okay, the most important thing is God can give you the go-ahead, just like he gave the Israelites the go-ahead that, I'm going to be leading you to the land of Canaan from the land of Egypt. He never told them they were going to pass through the desert. Are you getting a Kenny? Yeah, he never told them they were going to go through the Red Sea. He just gave the promise. So that is how it is in this case also. You have to apply wisdom. Wisdom is profitable to direct. It's not everything that God will do for you. There are some things he has given you as gift in order to replace some roles that you think he should play for you. All right, so you apply wisdom. Understand, play maturity, read books. Are you getting it? And make sure you do not try to imitate the world. Are you getting it? For example, people say it to, they say things to impress the other person. If you come to propose to me and you're trying to tell me your achievement, come on, you're going to discourage me because you're trying to present what you have achieved and not yourself. What if you are proposing to a nice lady, she wants you, she doesn't want your achievement. So make sure you prepare yourself very well before you go. Don't try to, you know, impress her. Just let her accept you the way you know you are, and you'll be very fine. So I repeat again, there is actually no specific way to carry out proposal. It can be different. Just make sure God is honored, this other person is respected, and that you give yourself some honors also, and you'll be very fine. I hope I was able to answer that question. Is that okay? All right, thank you so much, Kenny. I'm expecting other calls from other people. Thank you for joining. Please share the link and like the page. God bless you. Do have a great night. Bye. Yeah, hope you learned from that. Kenny just called saying probably Kenny is ready to make a proposal. He wants to make sure he does it right. There is nothing like doing things right. There are no two wrong things or multiple wrong things that can result into good result. Okay, so that is a major thing. Make sure you get it right. You don't have to be perfect. Don't try to be perfect, but make sure the basic things you need in order to achieve what you look forward to achieving, you put it in order. Okay, and I pray God will help you. And I hope those of us that are connected to the broadcast right now, I hope you can hear both me and also the person asking questions. Please, I need someone to confirm to be sure that our audio is perfect. Can you hear people calling in, and can you also hear me? Please, I need someone to do me a favor. I need someone to do me a favor by passing the comments. If you heard those that were calling in and you can also hear me clearly, help me to pass the comments. Or someone said yes, yes. Oh, anointed peace, patience, thank you so much. Okay, the number to call in again. Okay, 0809-222-2, that's 4 2s. Okay, sorry, 2 in 4 places, then 164. 0809, the number to call is 0809-2 in 4 places, then 164. 0809-222-2164. That is the number to call in order to interact, in order to ask your question. Ask it, you know, from any perspective. You're not going to be the only person that will benefit from it. Somebody somewhere also is going to benefit from the question you're going to ask. God bless you as to do so. All right. So as we wait for the next caller, I know the traffic is heavy. If we've missed your call yet, we'll definitely miss your call. Once we are attending to a question, definitely we'll miss your call. Keep trying. You'll get through. All right. So this is an interactive session with Mary Boyer. We are dealing with topics such as sex, marriage, dating, you know, love, finance, God, parenting, marriage proposal, and so many more. Whatever affects your love life, your romantic life, is what we're talking about tonight. So we'll be expecting your call. God bless you. Yeah, this is an interactive session. We're still expecting the calls. God bless you. You don't have to disclose your identity. I said it earlier. You don't have to. Okay? You can code your identity, still ask your question with the mind that somebody is going to benefit from it. God bless you. Yes. For those of us abroad, yes, you need to add the code. Okay. Patience is making a suggestion that you need to add 00234. Okay. Some you might need to add plus. Okay. Plus 234 before the number. Okay. So we have the next caller. Hello? Hello? Okay, we lost that. So thank you. Agbelushi Anuoluwaseun, thank you for re-echoing the number in the comments. All right, that's Kenny. God sent Kenny. Thanks for the perfect answer. Kenny called earlier. She tied you to the kitchen chair. She broke your throat and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the... As we wait for other color. Now, about... Let me buttress the point on... Okay, we have the next color. Let's quickly attend to... this person. Hello, good evening. Good evening. Can you speak louder? How are you? What's your name and where are you calling from? This is we are on live broadcast. Every other person can also hear you.
Yes, that is why I don't want to disclose my identity.
Oh, you don't have to disclose your identity. God bless you. So what is the question? So we can go straight to the question. God bless you.
I met this guy that was February this year, and we started being friends. Then on the 24th,
okay,
we started going out officially.
Okay.
Now, in between days, he traveled, he came down home.
Okay.
I saw him just once. He based in Port Harcourt.
Okay.
So, since then, we've been talking. We talked in a day very well. I mean, we can talk one afternoon and evening. We talk for hours.
All right.
We don't need a day without talking.
Okay.
But I don't feel like, is it wrong? Okay, I told him that I want to come over. I will enjoy to come and say, so we talked about sex. We've already ironed out the issue of sex.
Okay.
Like, it's a no sex relationship.
Okay.
So, someone just told me, or I heard some person saying, like, why would you be going out with a guy and you don't know where he is?
All right.
I don't know where he is, what that code and all that. And they, as a human being, I started feeling dumb how. So, he told me I'll be coming back. He's coming back. He's coming back home for the day.
All right. So, what is the question?
To know where he is, what that code by favorite. But everyone, what people have been saying and all that, I started thinking, okay, it's very necessary for me to go there. And we're talking about Ghana. He went on saying, I'm not going to come on the favorite that I wanted to come. And before we met, he was in a relationship and he engaged the law. And the relationship broke, as in before we met. So I asked him, like, what happened? How will we engage the girl? And the engagement was just great. So he explained a lot of things to me that,
all right,
that the girl is actually monitoring him. The girl doesn't give him business space. And all the girl cares about is marriage.
Okay. So what is the situation now with you? So that because we have a lot of people waiting to call. So what is the question?
My question is, why do you need to go there?
Okay.
This October.
Okay.
Or should I just calm down and see what the situation is till we come back and till next year, if favorite.
All right. Now, before you go, when you told him you will be coming, has he accepted to bring you in? Has he agreed that you can come? He has not. All right. Okay. All right. So I'm going to answer the question. Can they listen? Because other people will also benefit from this. This my lovely sister. She doesn't want to disclose her identity, and I respect that. Now, she's in a relationship with this guy, and they've been together for some time. They communicate. They're actually doing well. Yeah, they are actually doing well in the relationship. But at a point, people started asking her that, oh, you don't even know much about this guy. You don't know where he's staying. They are staying in two different states in Nigeria. That, why don't you pay him a visit? Then he threw it to the guy that, I want to come visit you, but the guy does not agree to it. Now, it's like beginning to come up like an issue now, and she's asking, do I have to go? Now, listen, my sister, can you hear me? All right, bless you. Now, listen, in whatever relationship you are in, make sure you are not in a relationship with a stranger. Okay, before you go ahead to say yes to someone's proposal, be very sure of where this relationship is leading to. You know, I know that most of the time when a guy asks a girl out or proposes to a girl, most of the time she's supposed to take some, you know, some personal time to herself in order for her to consider the proposal. Not that you just say yes immediately. Now, within a period of considering whether you're to say yes to him, what you do within that period is to know who this guy is. It's not just the look. It's not just the work. It's not just who he is. Where is he coming from? Where does he work? Where does he stay? I'm not saying you should go beginning to question him, but you just have to slow it down to make sure you're not starting a relationship with a stranger. Now, if the relationship is a serious relationship, both of you are adults, and you have not even known each other's house, you know, it means some things are still missing. Now, if you have, you know, chosen to know where he's staying, and then he's saying, no, I don't want you to force yourself on him. You better relax and don't go until he comes over. Then you sit down and discuss it. Know where this relationship is heading towards. From the look of things now, some things are not clear yet. Sincerely, he may not be hiding anything from you. Are you getting it? But there is need for you to sit down together. Once he comes back, I suggest you do not go to meet him in Port Harcourt. All right? So hold on, let him come. Then you sit down and hammer out things. Make your relationship a clear relationship. Know each other. If the relationship must continue, who is this guy? Where is he staying? Does he know anything about me? Or is just a relationship that is between me and him? A kind of relationship that cuts off the members of your family, cuts off your vital friends. That relationship is not a safe one. I'm not trying to discourage you. I'm just telling you the way it is. Any relationship, a man that is in a relationship with you, or a lady that is in a relationship with you, is looking forward to knowing who you are, those that, you know, matter to you in life. That is a relationship, not just you, and you alone. You cannot just the two of us. Except you are not planning to take the relationship further into building a home. Now, she made a statement that the previous relationship the guy had, that he lost, that they discussed about the relationship, and it was as if, he said, the reason why he cut off the relationship, excuse me, the reason why he cut off the relationship is this particular girl was pressurizing him for marriage. When you are in a relationship, and at the beginning of the relationship, you do not know where the relationship is heading towards, there may be a problem. And also, don't be the one pushing as the lady. So don't be the one pushing as the lady. Okay? Don't push. Don't push. Calm down. Let him be in charge. But make sure you are not in a relationship with a stranger. And, you know, you are not dealing with somebody you do not know for your own safety. I hope this helps, you know, and I pray God will help you. All right? God bless you. I hope this question was well answered. Okay? In case there are other things you wish to disclose that you didn't say during this, you know, open question, you can always still get in touch later. All right? But please don't go since he's not ready to welcome you for safety reason. And, you know, just let him come back. Then you sit down and talk about where the relationship is heading towards. And now, If you're out there and you can hear me as a single, you're in a relationship, and at the beginning of the relationship, you didn't talk about whether there will be marriage or not. You just started a relationship. That is a simple definition I gave to dating. You are trying to check, maybe it will work out into marriage. And at the beginning, you are not talking about marriage, okay? So now, when you come up to begin to pressurize the other person, most especially if you are the lady, talking about marriage, you are going to scare him away. Are you getting it? One of the things you should have done from the beginning is to know where the purpose of the relationship. I pray God will give you wisdom. I hope this helps. God bless you. We wait for other callers. It's an interactive session tonight with Mary Boye. God bless you. Let me see what people are saying. Any relationship trying to isolate is a dangerous one. Yeah, it is. Bidemi, thank you. Bidemi Yahaya. So thank you for that comment. Thanks a lot, ma. You have been a blessing. God bless you too. All right, we're waiting. Anyone that is ready to call in tonight, just make sure your question is as brief as possible so other people will have the time to call in. Hello, good evening. Yes, good evening. This is Mary Boye. We are on live broadcast and interactive session with Mary Boye. Okay, and may I know who is Hello. Calling and where you are calling from? You're calling from Bayelsa State.
Yes,
yeah, Bayelsa is in Nigeria. All right, how may we help you tonight? What is your question tonight? Please, kindly make it as brief as possible so that other people can have the chance to call in. God bless you.
Okay, I've been in a relationship with my guy for the past 10 years now.
For some years?
Hello, ma, can you hear me?
Okay, for how long have you been in the relationship?
26 years now.
6 years, okay.
Last year I went for National Youth Service. Before I went, after counting, I came back and I got engaged. And I went back. Before I came back, after my youth service, I discovered that the girl has gotten pregnant for me.
Okay.
So when I came, it was like, it was really strange. I keep on asking him, what's the problem? Is he money? Blah, blah, blah. Because after the engagement, he has not really gone to see my parents. So I was telling him, let me finish my new service. So
okay.
And blah, blah, blah. It was just really strange. So I was like, what is really happening? At one point, I was like, this is, don't want to tell me, don't want to problem to me. I angrily gave him back the ring. I just took the ring too. I'm no longer interested.
Okay.
I told one of my friends and he was like, you're too fast. You're not supposed to give him back the ring. You're supposed to be sitting down and know what is the problem.
Okay.
And when I called him one day and I sat him down with the person and was like asking me what on earth lies with the leader who makes you not to forgive me.
Okay.
And just like as you are dating and you get to get pregnant or to start complaining, it's like
all right.
Take time that that's exactly what you are just from. Like,
so
when I went to the first person, I say I'm left that the first time, second time without the first time and get to see and that guys because you are just from
all right.
Blah, 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 and all that.
So what is the question? Okay.
I don't know if I can still continue that kind of relationship.
Okay, is he still begging you to come back?
Yes.
All right. Okay, I'm going to go ahead. I want you to continue to join the broadcast. I'm going to cut the line so that you can listen to it from Facebook. Is that okay by you? Or you?
Yes,
all right. God bless you. Thank you for calling. And listen very attentively to the answer. Now, this, my pretty sister, is calling from Bayelsa, asking that she has been in a relationship for 6 years with this guy, and when she went for her youth corp service, she came back, I think in between or so, and they got engaged. The guy offered her a ring, they exchanged a ring, like they are both engaged, about to get married. And then before she finished her youth corp service, when she came back, the guy has impregnated a girl around. And she was annoyed. She threw back the engagement ring at him, you know. But now the guy is coming around asking for her forgiveness. What can she do? Now, this is my take on that. What has happened has happened. Fine, it may appear that even after marriage, will you still be able to trust him? Now that it has, you're already engaged, you are not married, okay? I would suggest that you involve your family members, most especially your parents, if your parents were involved in the engagement thing. Let them be officially involved in this incident. Let your own parents and his own parents, let them sit together. If they sat together to fix the engagement at the point where you exchanged the ring, you've got to go back, involve both family, let them sit down and let them know what has happened. This guy already got someone impregnated. Are you sure he has not secretly gotten married to this guy, to this lady? The family will have to get in touch with the lady, and things will have to be clearly stated before you can go ahead with the marriage with him, okay? So coming to beg you, fine. If he says it's a mistake, I don't say you shouldn't forgive him. You have to forgive him. We need to forgive in order for us to receive forgiveness. But after you might have forgiven him, there is need for you to sit down in a family circle and let things be discussed. Because as a matter of fact, your husband-to-be already has a child. And what happens to the woman that he impregnated? So these are the things that will have to be clearly stated. So that you don't enter into the marriage and face problem whereby the lady that was impregnated will have to be forced to become, you know, the second wife in the house. So these are the things that has to be clearly stated. Don't ignore the fact that both parents will have to be involved. I hope this helps a lot to handle this matter. If you still need to get in touch, I don't mind for you to get in touch. But please don't do it alone. A pregnancy is involved. A child is going to be involved. And it's this guy you are engaged with that you are going to get married, you know, to. Let both parents be involved. Since they were involved from the beginning for the engagement, let them be involved and let them iron out this matter together. From your own side, if you still love him, if you know that you can trust him enough for him not to misbehave, once you are finally wedded, please sit down and clear things. The position of the child that is coming, the position of the mother of the child, your own position as the wife-to-be, and the position of your husband-to-be. Let this be clearly stated in the family meeting. Don't ignore that. Forgive him, but don't ignore the family meeting. Let everybody be involved. And I pray God will give you wisdom and he will help you. Now, if you're listening to me and you are the guy, or you are not this particular guy, why should you cheat on someone, okay, to the point of, I know some people, they cheat on their partners and it doesn't result into pregnancy, so they don't even know they are cheating. But I encourage you, if you want a good home, be sincere in your relationship. Sincerely, a woman you are going to impregnate and you're not going to get married to her, you have turned her life into a halfway. Permit me to use that language. She's never going to remain the same again. Someone that has been admiring her is going to stop admiring her because she's going to be a single parent if you are not going to get married to him. When you are not ready to get married to someone, why should you put her in a family way? Even when you are ready to marry her, why don't you wait? You're getting ready to marry. Why should you cheat on yourself? Wait for this sex. Wait for it. It's better done once marriage is intact. And it's a sin against God Almighty when you have sex outside marriage. You are building a very wrong foundation for your home. See, if you eventually get married to this person that you desire and the other one that you have impregnated, you know, I've talked to so many people that, you know, that were impregnated like that. They were abandoned. Even when you keep sending money for the upkeep of the child, what about the destiny of this lady? Please stop it. And those of you that are just opening your laps to any guy, just anyhow, come on. Come on. It doesn't respect you. Any relationship you are, once there is sex, once sex gets involved, the respect the guy used to have for you will drop automatically. I stand to be corrected. Some guys can bear me witness. Sincerely, I hope we're flowing well. I hope people are listening to you and you're getting this point. You're in a relationship. The guy is saying that if he doesn't have sex with you, he's going to break the relationship. It means he's not the guy meant for you. Most of the time, you can't make a guy stay by giving him your body. You know, it will get to a point where he will think that, oh, I've been sleeping with her several times. Probably that is how other men sleep with her also. You're going to lose respect before her, before him. Come on, keep yourself for your husband till that night of the honeymoon. And I pray God will give you wisdom. Hope this helps. God bless you. As we wait for other callers, tonight is an interactive session. We're expecting questions from you. You don't have to disclose your identity. So many people have called tonight without disclosing their identity. Yeah, we respect your identity. You don't have to disclose it, but you can call. You can go ahead to call. God bless you as we wait for the calls. Hope somebody is learning something from tonight's interactive session. God bless you. Yes, somebody just said, like a reply to the lady that just called, that you deserve somebody better. Sincerely. Yeah, the number to call is 080-009-2222-164. That is the number to call. If you are calling from outside the country, you've got to add the Nigeria code plus 234. Then you remove the 40 from it and you dial the number. It will get through. All right. The number once again to call 080-9-2222-164. There are four twos you should put. The 164. 0-0-9-2-2-2-2-1-6-4. We expect your call. God bless you. I can see people's replies. Thank you. Oh, Joy Obot, I can see you. God bless you. Thank you for joining in this broadcast. Noel, I can see you. Yomi Ijebo, Anointed Peace. Oye Jobi Olayinka, I can see you. Mercy Ada, God bless you. Thank you for joining. Please like the page, share the link. Let someone get in touch. Okay, the lines are still on 0809-2222-164. That is the number to call to ask your question. You don't need to disclose your identity because, you know, of sensitive issues. No problem. But I know that by asking questions, so many people will also benefit in the process of attending to your question. So try to bless someone and make sure you get a clear head before you enter into marriage. Don't enter into marriage while issues are still pending in your relationship. Don't make that mistake. Let every issue be clearly stated. Every issue, let it be clearly stated before you go into the wedding or marriage proper. God bless you. So we have another caller. Good evening.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening, madam. How are you doing tonight?
I'm fine.
All right. So this is a live broadcast and it's a call-in live broadcast. So every other person can hear you also.
Okay.
All right. What is the question, please?
I got to know someone who stays abroad.
Okay.
Who is your friend?
Okay.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you clearly, madam.
Okay, I got to know someone who is friend. They live in Abroad together.
Okay.
So before he said he will come and see me, he was interested in marriage.
Okay.
Before he came down, he was like reaching out to me like every 2 weeks or 3 weeks.
Okay.
He wasn't like kidding. He doesn't discuss anything personal. So I didn't take him serious. I was saying that whenever he comes back, we can sit and I'll actually know whether he's serious.
Okay.
When he came, after spending time, the way he came to see me, he didn't even show that seriousness. He just made like one. When he went back, his behavior changed. At the time, he started complaining. Okay, when I got to know why he changed, he said that he was telling that my friend that when he came, as he was leaving, I didn't pack like items, a fish, and all those things for him to go.
Okay.
So I said to my friend that, you know, we're not even serious, we're not the time.
Okay.
I said that each time he continually repeated such mistakes, I apologize.
Okay.
Several times.
Okay.
But later, I got a visa over to that place.
Okay.
I was planning to go over and see my friend and then see him too. At that time, I didn't have any money enough for now to go.
Okay.
And I explained to him that I can't just go and borrow or leave and move my expenses because of I want to travel out.
Okay.
And I will speak to you as soon as I visa is still active. Whenever I have the money,
all right.
I'm making arrangements to travel. I would like to depend on someone. You just said I'm not serious.
So what is the question?
When I shifted it again to travel, I couldn't make it. I gave you the reason that whenever I'm ready financially, I will travel.
So
then he stopped reaching out to me.
Okay.
Once in a while, he just starts me up, and then he stopped.
Okay.
The one I'm talking to now, I don't really know why he.
Okay.
I continue talking to him, but I just.
I'll just move on. All right. All right. God bless you. Your question is very clear. So you can sit. Are you connected to the Facebook Live?
Yeah, to
the Facebook Live.
Yes.
All right. So if you want to drop, so you don't have to burn your credit, you can go ahead and drop. I'm going to answer your question now. God bless you. Thank you for calling. Yeah, this is my lovely sister that just called. A friend introduced her to another friend. Okay, whether something could come up for like marital relationship. Now, and they got connected, they started chatting. The guy, you know, is abroad and she is back here in Nigeria. Now, she said the guy is now beginning to behave funny. When he came around, he didn't really, like, he made up his mind and all that stuff. Now, this is what I'm going to advise you. If this guy is serious about you, you are going to see it. As in, the moment he came to Nigeria, he's going to make everything clear. Despite the fact that he came over to Nigeria sincerely, he didn't come because of you. Are you getting it? If he came because of you, he will have clearly stated the whole thing to solidify the relationship. You said it yourself. You said before he came, things were not even solidified. When he came too, things were not really still solidified. So I don't see him being serious about the relationship. I'm trying to be very sincere with you. I don't see this guy being serious with the relationship. So don't try to push yourself on him. As a lady, when a guy doesn't go extra miles to get you, he doesn't value you, you are like the one chasing him, it's not a good signal. There are some dangerous signals you should ignore in relationships, okay? You are a lady, you are the one trying to chase the guy, to give you a call, to impress him, every little thing, he will be the one to offend you, he will be the one to apologize. That relationship is showing so many danger signals. Please be very careful. For you in particular, I don't see this guy being ready for you. When a man falls in love with you, he goes extra miles. He doesn't wait to tell you. He doesn't wait to put it in order to want him to take you to his home. Somebody introduce him to you. There is nothing wrong for somebody to introduce somebody to you. Once both of you are mature, you can pray about it. You can consider it. It's not that somebody is imposing the relationship on you. So there is nothing wrong if anybody introduces anyone to you. Just make sure you know this person very well before you make up your mind to say you will marry him, okay? So I don't see him being ready for this relationship yet. So I think you should relax. You should withdraw a little bit. Let him take his time in case he's still putting some things into consideration. If he's going to call you, if he's going to get in touch with you, let him get in touch with you. But stop chasing him. You're like almost the one chasing him, okay? So you're going to stop. You're going to stop chasing him, okay? You have to stop chasing him. Let him take his time, okay? I think let him make the communication higher, not you trying to say, for 2 weeks, I've not heard from you. Someone is trying to fall in love with you. 2 weeks, he has not called, and, you know, he doesn't feel it. So please leave him. Let him take his time. I'm not condemning him. He may have his reasons. So just hold on and let him get in touch. You can always get in touch later, and God bless you. Let me quickly pick up this. Thank you, and I hope that helps. Good evening. Hello? 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 All right, we lost him. So as I was saying, so don't be the one to be like you're running after him. he is the guy, he's the one that wants you, he's the one that wants to marry you. Okay, so let him do the chasing. You are not to do the chasing. So leave him, let him take his time. Even when you eventually buy your ticket to travel abroad, all right, so we have to manage the situation with maturity. Don't try wanting to impress him or push yourself on him. No matter what your age is, it's better you're late before getting married than to get married to a wrong person. A man during courtship or relationship that doesn't respect you, he may find it difficult to respect you even in the marriage. So please be very sensitive. There are a lot of danger signals you must not ignore in your relationship. Okay, take note of that. You have to respect each other even before entering the relationship. I know people could pretend, but most of the time when someone is pretending, in one way or the other, there are some things you will see that you know that this person is not totally sincere, most especially when you are sincere with yourself. So I hope that helps, okay? And I pray God will give you wisdom and it shall be well with you. And as a guy, let me address you guys. Probably you wanted to assess her immediately she was introduced to you. Okay, what I would have suggested you should have done is not to engage her too deeply for her to have prepared her mind saying, okay, somebody is coming for me. So if your friend introduced her to you, I think you can just say hello if you want, or you hold on, okay? But don't develop a kind of relationship that she will have made up her mind that, oh, I got someone already, even when you have not proposed. And all of a sudden, you got in touch with her, I'll be coming to Nigeria. And there you came to Nigeria, you were not still forthcoming, okay? So I think you've got to make up your mind. When someone introduces someone to you, it's not bad, but make up your mind whether you are to go into a relationship or not. Anytime I say this all the time, I'm going to repeat it once again this night. Once you're not ready to go into a romantic relationship with anyone, don't create the impression. Don't try to rally around the person. Don't try to too much check on her, okay, or on him to create such impression. And all of a sudden, you withdraw to say, at least I've not proposed. It's not okay. It means you're playing with somebody's emotion. So please be mature about these things. Marriage is not a game. It's just a reality and a solid part of life. You've got to get it right. And I pray God will give you wisdom in the name of Jesus. Thank you for calling. I hope this helped. And I hope other people are getting something from this to also help them. Sincerely, one person's question can address a million people. Okay, so just let us be attentive. And I'm very sure God is going to bless us. While we wait for the next caller, okay, we're still expecting the next caller. The number to call is 0809-222-222-164. That is the number to call. You're calling from outside the country. You've got to add the Nigerian code, which is +234. Then you remove the first zero from the number and you dial it together and you get through. God bless you. Thank you for connecting tonight. And let me see what people are passing as comments. God bless you. People are praying for me. I'm grateful. This is great. I'm grateful. God bless you. Oh, someone is saying, can you check your inbox? Oh, that may be a little bit difficult for me. I'm so sorry. Somebody wants me to check my inbox to see the questions. It's better you try to call. You don't have to disclose your identity. Well, I will try my best to check. God bless you. We're still waiting for your calls. The number to call is 0809-222-164. Somebody say check your inbox. So if you sent that question in that name, I'm trying to check it. So what's the name? Okay. Please, I'm not going to encourage for you to send questions inbox so that it can help. All right, I understand. Okay, we have the next caller. Hello, good evening.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening. This is Mary Boye. We are on a live broadcast, and this is an interactive session, a call-in interactive session. Every other person is hearing you as well. Okay.
Actually, I want to ask a question.
Please go ahead.
Actually, I have this fiancé, my fiancé.
Okay.
Actually, I'm listening to people.
Okay.
And he has come to see my pastor.
Okay.
Actually, I'm in China, so he's good.
Okay.
But I discover something, like somebody like me, I don't like taking people's phone.
Okay.
I don't like looking at people bad, going into all those things.
All right.
But I'm just struggling my team to do that, which I did.
All right.
And I thought we had ungodly cats with some people that you were chatting with.
Okay.
Like all these kind of chats, maybe when you are chatting with a woman, lady, and you are saying, the lady is going to hold my hair and I see. Those kind of ungodly chats.
All right.
So I was like, I'm asking. I didn't go to that. I didn't let him know that I've been thinking about this and seeing some ungodly chats like this.
Okay.
So I just asked him, I said, you don't have any body. I'm taking someone else. Tell you. I said, if you expect, if you have someone that you can only call yourself, because 3 years. Like something like that. I think it's not really true. We do not think that they only just start. I hold on. But when I saw that, I'm not able to confront that I saw your chat, that all this kind of thing that you are doing. So, like you are telling what you tell us emotion.
All right. So, what is the question?
I should break the relationship or I should go ahead. And
okay.
I think that I'm seeing some bad things that.
Okay.
So
all right.
I don't really, I don't want to advise me
on what to do. All right.
He's
chatting with. All right, my sister. All right. Thank you for calling. I got that clearly. So I'm going to go ahead to give you my advice. Okay. So you may want to drop the phone. So you don't burn your credit, so you can listen to it in the broadcast on Facebook. Is that okay by you?
Yes.
All right. She's in a relationship with this guy. This guy has gone very far with her in the relationship. They have met each other's families, pastors, okay, which gives us the signal that he knows what he's doing and he's so sure of you know, being in this relationship. Now, she is suddenly, you know, dumping on his phone and came across his chats with some other ladies, and she calls it ungodly chats, calling someone sweetheart and other stuff. Okay, this is my advice for you. Now, you have actually seen what is going on with this guy. Whether he tells you that he's in a relationship with any other person or not, you've actually been able to see it yourself, that there is something going on with him. A major thing I would advise you to do is you're going to sit him down. You're going to sit him down and you're going to make everything clear. There is no need to hide, okay? If it's true that he's the one indulging in such conversation, you've got to call him. You've got to tell him that I came across these conversations on your phone. What is going on? All right, so there is nothing to hide. So hear from him. Whatever he says will determine the next step you will take. So I hope he's sincere enough to tell you the truth. And in case he's in a relationship, okay, in case he's actually in a relationship with other people, come on, it is a danger signal for you. You may really not be able to go on with that relationship. But there is need for you to, you know, to talk about it. Don't just assume. fine, you've seen it on his phone. Don't just decide and make up your mind and just say, I can't continue. Sit him down, talk about it. Now that your pastor is aware, he has seen your pastor, you've got to see your pastor also. After you might have discussed with him, you've got to tell your pastor what is going on. Your pastor has to contribute because your pastor is already involved in the relationship. I pray God will give you wisdom. Don't do it alone, and the Lord is your strength. Keep praying, okay? Trust God, all right? And don't be brokenhearted. I know you are emotionally affected already, but what has happened, but thank God you saw it. Imagine that it's after you've gotten married and you're seeing something like this. So it can be handled now. It's not too late. I hope this helps. It shall be well with you. God bless you for calling. If you still need to get in touch after the broadcast, you can. Bless you. Hello? Hello, good evening. This is Mary Boye. This is Mary Boye. Hello?
Hello, my name is Billy Odulami.
Okay, Odulami, good evening, sir. How are you doing?
I'm fine.
All right, so can we hear your question?
Yes, I'm online now. I'm in the program.
Oh, thank you so much, sir. Thank you. God bless you. So what is the question?
Yes, I want to ask about this family issue. When a man and a woman is married, they are having baby kids, children are within the house, the family, and they never care. So cover themselves, we call it the family grouping or family thing. The children can be their recognition anyhow, at any age, and it's affecting the family. How do you do this? What is your perception about this and what advice would you give?
All right. And
who are going to allow their children
okay. to be their okay. and what their I need to understand. Sorry, sir. I need to. Okay. I need to understand. All right, thank you. I need to understand the question. It's not clear to me yet. You said in a situation where we have husband and wife, and they have children, right? Okay, and the children...
They don't care to cover the
kids. Okay. Okay. Okay, you mean, is it the parents... Sorry, is it the parents that don't cover themselves or the children?
The parents.
Oh, now I understand you, sir. All right. Okay, very good. So I'm going to give my view on that. If you need to cut the phone, you can go ahead and cut. So you join the live broadcast. Is that okay, Baye? God bless you. Thank you for calling. Yeah, he's asking. He said there is this family where in the family the parents don't care. They can leave themselves naked and the children are around. That was your view about that. It's not good. That is not good. If you are a parent, no matter how free you choose to be with your family, please cover your nakedness. The children we have nowadays, I don't know, maybe it's the high-tech children, but I know that God gave them to us. But the way they reason, the questions they ask now, some of them are unbelievable. So don't think your baby at home is still very young and he doesn't understand some things. Cover your body, okay? If you need to show your nakedness, let it be between you and your spouse in your room. Before the children, please cover up and cover up very well. All right, please, you can create very bad impression for the children and you think they don't know, even when they don't talk. In fact, if you have kids that don't often talk about what they see, they don't often ask questions about what they see at home, you should be very concerned. You should be very concerned. And if you are in that category, and some couples too, that sleep in the same room with their children and they have sex in that room, with the children sleeping in the room, you assume the children are sleeping. If you are staying in a one-man room with your children, please create a demarcation from your bedroom, your bed, the corner where your bed is. Please let there be a curtain, okay, that separates you from where the children are sleeping. Don't you ever think they are sleeping while you are having sex in the night. Some of them may be very awake. Are you getting it? Please be very sensitive. What you do, okay, matters a lot. What the children grow with are the things they pick from you. Be very sensitive and don't be careless with these children. I pray God will bring up your children in a godly way for you and with your support in the name of Jesus. So I hope I was able to answer that question clearly. It's not a good thing. Don't open up yourself at home anyhow because you just want your kids to be free with you. Please be very sensitive. It's not a good thing to do. I hope that's okay by you. God bless you. The number to call once again is 0809-222-2164. If you're calling from abroad, you've got to add the Nigeria code to the number +234 or 00234 for the number, then you'll be able to get through. God bless you. God bless you. I'm seeing people's comment. The pregnancy is an opportunity to know the man is unfaithful. Yes. So people are responding to some of these questions. They are also making their contribution, which is very okay. Please, beyond what I say, you can go ahead to read the comments. Okay. You will definitely learn from something, from someone's comments. God bless you. Yeah, someone is saying I should check my inbox. Hello, good evening. Hello? Yo, we missed that. The number to call 0809-222-164. Yeah, I'm trying to check some other questions that were thrown as inbox to me. Please don't, you don't have to throw your own question to the inbox because it might be a little bit distracting to read such. We'll definitely still be coming up with another session of the interactive session. And if you prefer not to call, but to send in your question, definitely once we'll create time for that to attend to it. God bless you. We have another caller. Good evening.
Hello, good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, sir. How are you doing tonight? Yeah, I'm cool also. Yeah, we are live. This is a live broadcast. Everybody can also hear you. Hope you are aware, right?
Yeah, sure, I hear.
All right, so what's the question?
First of all, my name is Marcos, to start with.
Okay, where are you calling from?
I'm calling you from Abuja.
From Abuja.
Nigeria.
All right, sir. Okay.
Well, today happens to be my very first time listening to your show and watching your show as well.
Wow, thank you. Yeah.
And it's courtesy of a friend that I don't want to mention her name right now.
No problem, no problem.
Yeah,
that's good.
She's somewhere in the Europe.
Okay, that's good. That's good. Thank you.
Yeah, she's your fan. She follows you like all the time, like everything.
Wow, that's. Please say hello to her. Thank you so much. All right.
She's watching and she's listening as well. But she gave me your number and she's been able to push.
Okay, that's good. Thank you. Yeah.
You're welcome. I have a question too.
Okay.
Yes, and my question goes like this. What has been married? Let's say, for instance, I've been married for about 8 years, right? Okay. And God has blessed the union with a couple of kids. Right?
Okay. Okay.
And one day like that, there was no major argument. No major misunderstanding, you know, just a normal misunderstanding that, you know, couples do have once in a while.
Sure.
And by the grace of God, they have been able to deserve it without a third party. Right?
Okay.
And after some time, the woman decides to leave the house.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Of course, the man loves his wife and of course his family. So he went to her home and all of that to make sure that the woman returned home.
Okay.
But all his efforts so far proved abortive, right?
Okay.
And the woman left. After 2 to 3 years, she's now calling the man to come back.
That
according to her in her work, she said something was behind it. She she wasn't out. She doesn't know what was wrong, what was remoting her and all of that.
Okay.
You know, she loved her kid and all of that and all of that.
Okay.
And remember, when she was away, she never said about the kid. She never call or come to pay them a visit one day.
Okay.
She disappeared for like a couple of years, and now she's back. She's returned, according to her, she's back to take care of her kid.
Mm-hmm.
So in such a situation, what do you advise the man to do?
All right, thank you for calling, sir. That's a very sensitive question. So if you don't mind, for you not to burn your credit, you might want to drop the phone and listen very attentively. I'm going to give my view on that. Is that okay by you?
Yeah, that'll be perfect.
All right, thank you so much for calling. Now, this is my view concerning the issue that my friend just gave. He said this woman left after 8 years in marriage. They've been blessed with kids. And the wife just left, you know, the house because they had a misunderstanding. Now, after 2-3 years, she's calling to come back. What can this man do? The first thing I will ask if I meet the man is what actually happened? What could have happened after 8 years? What type of minor misunderstanding that could make a woman to leave her kids and her lovely husband? And for 2 years, she was away. She was not even getting in touch. What was it that happened? If I have access to that information, I'll be able to, know what to say in details. But now that I do not have that information, now she's trying to come back and she claims she was spiritually manipulated. So that was the impression he was trying to create, that the woman is now saying like she didn't know what was wrong with her. Okay, that there had been arguments previously. Why should this particular one lead her to live in her home? It's strange, okay? It's strange. It shouldn't be. No matter what happens between you and your spouse, please, don't you ever carry your bag to move out of the home, except you have an ulterior motive of where you're going. I know there are spiritual instances where it is true for someone to be manipulated out of his place of destiny. I know there are cases like that. But before we accuse the devil for the mistakes we are making, let us first of all deal with ourselves. The devil doesn't just come from nowhere to say, leave your home. Something must have led to something. Even though if your husband impregnated someone, it doesn't want it for you to leave your home, leave your kids for 2 years. No. No matter the gravity of the offense of your husband, if it is so huge that you feel like leaving home, don't leave, I can tell you. Involve those that you respect so much. It has gotten to that, okay? It has gotten to that instead of leaving, since you can't discuss it, you can't sit down to discuss the matter together, it means you might need to involve the third party. The third party you involve matters also. Don't involve anyone who doesn't have a good testimony maritally. Don't involve anyone who doesn't have a good heart. Don't involve anyone who doesn't have a clear mind concerning your family. Someone who is not totally free with your family. Probably somebody that is a little bit envious. So be sensitive to involve the right person when the matter has aggravated so much and you feel like leaving your home. Don't you for any reason leave your matrimonial home, no matter what the case is. Now, someone might want to say, what if it involves domestic violence where my husband or my wife is about killing me? Okay, involve the third party at that point, okay? And let them give you godly counsel. What happened that is pushing you into doing that thing? Something, we have to hold on to something. So, you know, build the habit to sit down with your spouse to clear your matters rather than just, you know, angrily taking action. Any decision you take out of anger, you will definitely still regret it, sincerely. There was a case with an uncle of mine. You know, the wife got to know that he impregnated someone. Okay, and he called the wife. Let's talk about it. Yes, I did it. It's true. I impregnated her. She already has a child. I'm sorry. Let's talk about it. Her friend advised her to leave the home. And she left. Till I'm talking to you now, for more than 10 years, the husband couldn't take her back. Okay? The husband said it's a taboo in his family for a woman to just leave and come back, that she might come back wanting to kill him, you know, and all those stuff. So don't follow a wrong counsel that will entirely scatter your home. You can have challenges. A home where you don't have issues at all, I will be suspicious. Something is hidden somewhere. So you could have differences, but build the habit to settle your differences. So if you are the husband, my counsel for you is don't just take her in. Okay? She has gone for two, three years. What was she doing with herself and what were you doing with yourself? She was not even calling to check on the children. You have to be sure you are safe by the time she comes back. I'm trying to be very sincere with you. You must have missed your wife. No sex, or maybe you had an alternative. No sex for 2-3 years. She didn't check on the children. She was not calling. And she just woke up all of a sudden that she's coming back home. Something is wrong somewhere. Don't do it alone. Don't just say, okay, come back. Don't just open the door of the house. In case she needs, you need to involve, you know, spiritual assistance. All right? Maybe prayer, counsel, and all those stuff. If she was truly manipulated, she has to be prayed for. The manipulation may still be inside there to even do some other wrong things by the time she comes home. So I advise you, don't just open the door of the house for her to come in. She's your wife, okay? She's your wife, I understand. But I don't feel comfortable allowing you to bring her in after not getting in touch for 2-3 years. Involve those that you respect. And if you are Christians, involve those you respect in God. In the matter, let more mature people, let them sit with both of you and discuss with you. Let her tell you what was going on within those 2-3 years that she was away. What actually happened that she went? Don't just blame the devil. What happened? Something happened. You've got to get a clear understanding of what happened because of the nearest future, so it doesn't repeat itself again. So that is just my take in that. I hope it helps. Now, let me say this generally. Separation, when someone is separated with a spouse for years, we've had instances where when they come together, the other person has already contracted some, you know, sexually transmitted diseases, and by the time they come together, the other person is infected, and you know, the person loses his life or her life because of the carelessness of the other person. When you had a very long period of separation with your spouse and then you are reconciling, we've been praying for people to reconcile. That is one of the mandates of God upon my life, that people, homes should not be separated. Okay, you've got to come back, you know, reconcile. But before you eventually come together to start living as husband and wife again, please let other people be involved. Let them counsel you. I will also advise that both of you go for tests. Go for tests. I hope there is no sexually transmitted disease and other stuff. Okay, after a long period of separation, please don't just be careless. Talk about it. Apply wisdom. Wisdom, the Bible says, is profitable to direct. And you know, Jesus in a parable says, he said, be wise as serpents, okay, and be gentle as dove. Okay, if Jesus could compare wisdom to that of the serpents, you know, if it were people like me talking about serpents, probably somebody will say, oh, she's demonic. Why would she be citing an example of a serpent? It was our Lord Jesus Christ. He wants you to be so wise that he had to, you know, he had to compare the wisdom you need more than the wisdom of that of a serpent. You know how a serpent operates, okay? So you can read about that for you to know that you need wisdom to run the affairs of your life, even in the midst of challenges, and most especially now that we are in this end time, so many issues are coming up. I pray your own home and relationship will not fall victim of the snare of the enemies in the name of Jesus. I hope that helps. God bless you and thank you for calling. I will take 2 more callers tonight. I will go to bed. God bless you. I'll take 2 more calls tonight. Then I will let us call it a break. Yeah. The next 5 minutes, if we are fortunate to get 2 more callers, we'll attend to them and we will go to bed. God bless you. So there are people that are making their own contribution apart from what I'm saying. People are also passing their own comments, like additional comments to my own view. You can please go ahead and read these comments. It will definitely help. It's like we are learning from one another. That is why it's an interactive session. I'm giving my views. Some other people are giving their views also. By the time we combine all these things together and you filter them with the wisdom of God, you'll be good to go. It shall be well with you in Jesus' name. Yes, the number to call, once again, people are asking, the number to call 0809-222-2164. 0809-2 in four places, then 164. You're calling from outside Nigeria. You've got to add the Nigeria code. +234, you remove the first zero, and you die, you get through. God bless you. All right, so if we do not have any other caller tonight, we're going to call it a night and not a day so that we can go to bed. And this is my parting words for everybody. Thank you once again for joining me on this interactive session. I pray God will perfect all that concerns you. One of the things I've been able to absorb from all the people that shared their worries so that we can talk about them tonight, I discovered that wisdom is a tool that all of them need to apply in the situations they have met themselves. You see, wisdom is profitable to direct. If you have chosen to be a child of God, you have chosen to live your life to glorify God, sincerely, you need wisdom. And Jesus is the wisdom of God. You need Jesus at every point of your life. And let me say this. I know there are so many people that have already become so disappointed with some Christians or with some spiritual leaders. Now, if a church has failed you, if a spiritual leader has failed you, if some Christians have failed you with the way they are living their life, you see it that these things are not in accordance with the scripture. And, you know, they are there and they go ahead because nobody knows about it. And that is how they are living their life. Now, don't let the misbehavior of any other person determine what you will do with your life. Don't say because somebody is misbehaving in the church and as a result of that, you are going to stop serving God. You are going to stop serving God. No. Nobody should be strong enough to separate you from God. The Bible says, what can separate us from the love of the Lord? Is it temptation? Is it tribulation? What is it that is strong enough to separate you from God? So no matter the misbehavior of people you see that call themselves, spiritual people, and you see them misbehaving, they are not Jesus. The Bible says, look unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. The reason why the Bible says you should look unto Jesus, you will see a lot of things that will get your attention. So don't get carried away by these things. Study your Bible to know more about God. Have a personal relationship with God. It's for your own good. There are so many secret things going on all over the place. People are no longer sincere. So many falsehood. But in the midst of being forceful, or in the midst of this falsehood attitude of people, there are still some sincere people that are there. So be sincere with yourself, be sincere in your relationship with God, and God will connect you with the right person. And I pray it shall be well with you. There's not going to be a live broadcast tomorrow. Yes, there's not going to be any live broadcast tomorrow. But by Saturday, there's going to be a live broadcast. There's going to be an interactive session. Same time by 9 p.m. UTC +1. That is with the West Africa time. On Saturday, 9 p.m., there's going to be a live broadcast also. The interactive session is going to continue, but we are going to include some teachings to it. Please, as a matter of reality, in your relationship, if you're facing challenges, that's not the end of the world. Don't just, out of anger, take decision. Seek for godly counsel. Talk to someone about it. Okay? And don't try wanting to secure the relationship and you are enduring things. There are some things you endure during courtship. When you get to the marriage, there might be what will blow the marriage apart. So there are certain things you cannot just keep quiet over. Okay? And I pray God will give you wisdom. So once again, I appreciate you for joining me in today's broadcast. And I hope you were sincerely blessed in the course of trying to attend to people's, questions. And I pray it shall be well with you. See you same time on Saturday night at 9 for another live broadcast on this same platform with Mary Boye. God bless you. Remember to like the page. I need you to keep going. I need you to like the page. Share the link. And I pray God bless you. Thank you. And you have a lovely night rest. Goodbye. Remember, the broadcast is going to be on Saturday. It's not going to be tomorrow, Friday.